A population of rabbits oscillates 100 above and below average during the year, hitting the lowest value in January, which is when t equals 0. The average population starts at 950 rabbits and increases by 5% each month. We want to find an equation for the population p in terms of t, where t is the number of months since January. So our equation p, or p of t, will actually consist of two functions. We'll have an oscillating function, which will be a sinusoidal or trig function, and then we'll have an exponential function that models the non-oscillating growth. So let's say that p of t will equal f of t plus g of t, where again, f of t will be the oscillating part, and g of t will be the exponential growth part. So to begin, let's focus on the oscillation part, which will control the oscillation 100 above and below the average during the course of a year, hitting the lowest point at t equals 0. Once we find this part of the function, we'll then come back and find the exponential growth part, which starts at 950 and increases by 5% each year. The oscillation part of our equation is going to resemble the cosine function, which we see graphed here. So for a quick review, if we take a look at the cosine function over one period from 0 to 2 pi, and then break this period up into four equal intervals, starting here and ending here, so you break it in half and then in half again, there is a distinct pattern. Notice it starts at a maximum value, then it's at the midline, then a minimum, then the midline, and then a maximum. So we can use this pattern to graph the oscillation part of our growth function, and then find the equation, for the oscillation part. Well, because the oscillation occurs over 1 year, and we're dealing in months, the period will be 12. So from here to here, we should be able to graph one complete period of the oscillation part. We know it oscillates 100 above and below average, but it hits the lowest value when t equals 0, which means when t equals 0, if x is the midline, the function value would be negative 100 here. So this is actually going to be a minimum, where on the basic cosine function, it would be a maximum. But if we now divide this period into four equal parts, or four intervals, we should be able to follow a similar pattern, except our function will be reflected across the x-axis. So if we divide the interval from 0 to 12 into four equal intervals, we'd cut it in half, and then cut it in half again. And now because we're starting at a minimum, if we add 1/4 of the period, we'd be back at the midline here. If we go over 1/4 of the period from here, we'd be actually at a maximum. Then we'd be back at the midline, and then back at a minimum here. So the graph of just the oscillation part of our function would look something like this. And because this resembles the cosine function, we'll find the equation of the cosine function using this form of the equation. Remember, the absolute value of A is the amplitude. We can see our amplitude is 100, but because we have a reflection across the x-axis, A would actually be negative 100. So A equals negative 100. And then the period is controlled by B, where the period is 2 pi divided by B. And since our period is 12, if we set 2 pi divided by b equal to 12, we can solve for b using this equation. So we can cross multiply or multiply both sides of the equation by b. That would give us 12b equals 2 pi. Dividing both sides by 12, we have b equals pi divided by 6, which means the equation for the oscillation part of our growth model would be f of t equals negative 100 times cosine of pi divided by 6 times the input variable of t. Again, where t is the number of months. Now let's take f of t back to the previous slide and find the exponential growth part of our equation. So again, now we know that p of t is equal to f of t plus g of t, where f of t is negative 100 times cosine of pi divided by 6 times t plus g of t, where g of t is the exponential growth part of our equation. which we'll write in the form of y equals a times b to the x, where a would be the initial value and b would be the base of the exponential function. Well, the initial value is the starting population of 950. And now our base, because the growth rate is 5% per month, would be 1 plus 5% as a decimal. That would be 0.05 raised to the power of t. Notice after every month, we'd multiply by 1.05. The 1 represents the original population, and the 0.05 represents the 5% growth. So let's go ahead and simplify this. We would have p of t equals negative 100 times cosine of pi divided by 6 times t plus 950 times 1.05 raised to the power of t. This would be our population equation in terms of t, where t is the number of months since January. Before we go, let's take a look at this graph. Here it is. Notice how the general trend is exponential growth, but we can also see the oscillation of 100 above and below the average throughout the year. I hope you found this explanation helpful.